Lisecki has spent the past 5 years as Bishop of La Crosse.
Only on 12, our Patrick Palantonio reports how Lisecki sees his role as leader of his flock.
The Most Reverend Jerome Lisecki says he was 3 years old when he saw a priest walking near his home and told his parents, "That's what I want to be." When he was a teenager, he spent his summers working in a steel mill to earn money for seminary. And after ordination, he spent 20 years as an Army chaplain, retiring with the rank of lieutenant colonel. Tomorrow, he adds the title of Archbishop, bidding goodbye to the Diocese of La Crosse and taking another leap of faith.
Winter settles in on the banks of the Mississippi River, quietly taking up residence in La Crosse, Wisconsin. This is small-town America, a neatly outlined city of 50,000 people, spreading out across a valley, embraced by a ring of towering bluffs. Here, Mother Nature's blessings create a sanctuary that some call God's country, including Archbishop-designate Jerome Lisecki.
I wish I could put people in my own body and look through my own eyes, you know, when I celebrated Rural Life Day and saw this community. We're celebrating a mass, giving thanks to God for the crops, for the family farm. It's Americana. Again, I wish I could have taken people through my own eyes and maybe even used a camera here, you know, to kind of try to capture that.
While sounding a bit nostalgic about his time in La Crosse, this archbishop-to-be sounds equally confident about finding that small-town spirit in Milwaukee's neighborhoods.
When you take a look at the neighborhood, when you have a sense of knowing the people that are there, you have a concern about how Mrs. Murphy is going to get hers or snow shoveled from the sidewalk, if you have a concern about Mr. Johnson and getting to maybe his therapy or his treatment, you know, for something, it's bringing that spirit to the fore and understanding that really kind of it's an extension of what we celebrate in terms of our humanity.
Humanity is a big topic with this man of the cloth. He says he loves people and finds life fascinating. He'll talk about anything, food or faith, politics or basketball.
Thank you very much for mentioning basketball. I love the sport. People toss upon me the various interests, whether it be in law or canon law or studies or teaching. The one common thread, and it's always been, is my desire to serve the church as priest. I see my role as trying to assist people, to help people come to Christ, to be a vehicle of that. So we all have separate vocations that the Lord has basically called us to. But our common vocation, one that if you want, transcends all of those individual calls, is holiness. And that is to understand the other as God, and to understand how God is manifesting himself in our lives, whatever situation, circumstance we're called into, to draw us closer to the Lord.
But with so many people facing tough times, unemployment and uncertainty, are people leaning on their faith or losing it?
When we're experiencing at least good times or beneficial times, you know, when we experience those, you know, there's always a tendency to say, well, I did it. You know, I pulled myself up by the bootstraps. But when we're hit, you know, critically, we've got to take a look at, you know, where do I turn? To whom do I turn? And it's there where suddenly, you know, hopefully I as a leader say, you turn to God. And God will give you that internal strength. It will not result in a quid pro quo. Well, I'm going to do this, God, so you're going to give me this, you know. What it will hopefully result in is a deepening of the character of the individual.
And the bishop believes character is needed now more than ever, whether confronting issues of faith or politics.
When someone says, well, I'm going to refrain from politics, you know, I'm not going to vote, I'm not going to share my opinion, this is just a wasted effort or wasted time, they do a disservice to that community in which they're a part of. Too oftentimes we look at politics merely as supporting, you know, the political positions of one party or the other party, when really the political discourse is really about trying to understand what's best for the community, and also to make sure that the voices representing the various interests are truthful about what they represent.
Archbishop-designate Jerome Lisecki says he knows people will be listening to his stances on issues and will judge him by that same standard of truthfulness.
What you see is what you get. You know, there isn't basically a hidden agenda. I believe we're engaged in the greatest activity we can be engaged in, that being church. You know, I celebrate that. I love that. I hope I can bring others to that understanding. And I have a real sense of a family. And I'm going to approach the Archdiocese of Milwaukee as family and basically care for them on that level.
A promise made to a new hometown as it settles into winter. A larger city with a familiar small-town feel. On the water and blessed by Mother Nature. For the new Archbishop, another place to call God's country.